реакция нашего общества, к сожалению, политическая.
Between Alexei Navalny's poisoning and the crisis in Belarus, Russia may be hit with more sanctions soon from Western countries. But this time, it may not be as worried as from previous hits. The impact would likely be muted. Russia has been preparing for the possibility of future sanctions since the first wave in 2014. These are the five ways it has laid the groundwork, starting with its reserves. Russia has the world's fourth largest gold and foreign currency reserves, which have been steadily building over 5 years. The central bank also let the ruble float freely in 2014, making it a safe valve against external shocks. Secondly is oil, Russia's main export. To shield itself from volatility in prices, the government changed its fiscal rule in 2017, so that any crude oil revenue over a certain price goes right into the state's coffers. When prices dip, Russia sells foreign currency, supporting the ruble. It's reduced its dependency on external markets, slashing foreign debt exposure and boosting domestic borrowing. Outstanding foreign debt has shrank considerably over the years. Russia's also come up with other domestic buffers. For example, it's made its own credit card payment system, fearing it would get cut off from the likes of Visa and MasterCard. It's made its own bank messaging system, its own credit rating agency, and others, all reducing its dependency on the global financial system. Finally, it's reduced its reliance on imports. Russia has become more self-sufficient in food since it banned most Western imports in 2014. This ban and a weaker ruble have helped domestic producers flourish, reducing Russia's food imports by a third since 2013.